Hello everyone, welcome to Let's DevOps, myself Sumit, and today we are going to discuss about how to trigger GitHub Actions workflow from another workflow. And for all the demo and description, I will be following this article, and the link of this article is available in the video description. Now let's start. So first is the introduction. So from the title itself, you are aware that we are going to talk about how to trigger workflow from another workflow. And this will help in multiple use cases when you are required to trigger other workflow on same or a different repository. Okay. Talking about the architecture, basically we will have one or more workflow where one workflow can be triggered from the another workflow. And this can be achieved through the repository dispatch as well as a Python script. Talking about the use case, so basically this method we can use in a multiple use cases. One example, if I can say, assume that I want to trigger workflow 2 whenever the workflow 1 fails, right? So that is the one use case you can assume. Second is like maybe you have a multiple workflow and you wanted to have a dependency, like you wanted to make sure the workflow 2 completes before workflow 1, right? So that kind of a use case or technique you can use with the help of this particular demo and the description. Okay, so talking about the method of trigger, so we already discussed earlier, like we can use repository dispatch, right, which will help to trigger the workflow. But we can also add some more limitation, or maybe you can say that assume that you have a 5 workflow, right, and all of them has a repository dispatch. So whenever the workflow 1 will understand which repository dispatch it needs to pick up. So for that, basically we need to add a event type. So here if you see, we are adding the event type as a workflow 2. So whenever there is a payload request with the type of workflow 2, then only this particular workflow will get triggered. So we'll discuss that more in the demo also. I will show some of the basic example so that you can understand more on it. Talking about the setup, so as part of this process, we will set up two workflow, workflow 1 and workflow 2. In the workflow 1, basically we use to trigger the workflow 2, right? So we'll have some setup on the workflow 1 which helps to trigger the workflow 2, right? So here if you see, here we have mentioned the workflow 1 is the triggering workflow and the workflow 2 will be the trigger workflow. Okay, now let's see the workflow 1 setup. So here is I have one sample workflow which I have created. It is publicly available, so you can just click on it and it will open this particular page. So let's try to review this workflow and how basically this is the workflow 1. If I mention how we have made a configuration of workflow 2 so that it will trigger that workflow of the workflow 2, right? So first of all, if you see, this is the name of the workflow 1, right? And we are passing some of the information because we need to trigger workflow 2, right? So what is the name of the workflow? So in our case, it is a workflow 2. What is the account where this particular workflow exists? And third, what is the repository, right? So that is also very important because the workflow can be on a same repository or it can be on a different repository as well. So one more important part is that the path token, right? So that also you need to configure in the sense of this is like the pack token of the workflow 2, right? So that configuration you need to make in the workflow 1, right? So here if you see, and if you see, we are basically using a Python script. This Python script can be found in this particular repository itself, like under the deployment script we have a workflow trigger, and whenever we are calling this particular Python script, we are passing some information of workflow 2. Okay, so let's go here and see the deployment script, right? So here we have the trigger, the Python script. So it's doing nothing, it's just kind of picking the information like a token, owner name, repo name, and there are some payload which you are we have configured here. Like this is just for information, like if you want to send some information from one workflow to another, like workflow 1, I want to pass the baseline number, I want to pass the baseline revision number. If those thing I wanted to pass, I can send that as a payload, right? So we are basically here, we are making a REST API call where we are passing the workflow name and the baseline number and the revision number. So one thing here, if you noticed, we are providing the event type as a workflow name. So it means that wherever there is a repository dispatch with the event type workflow name, in our case we are passing workflow 2, right, that workflow will get triggered with this particular REST API call. Okay, so let's go back to the tower article now and talk about the configuration. So here if you see, in this workflow 1 we need to provide this particular detail of workflow 2, like what is the workflow 2 name, what is the GitHub account repo, what is the pack token, and then the payload details. So right now I am passing only 2. Maybe as per your requirement, if you want to pass some more details, you can pass through the payload, right? So payload basically is the data which can be sent through the REST API call, and this is the trigger, the workflow trigger Python script, and that is available in this location. This location is also publicly available, so you can have a look to it. Talking about this, this is the workflow, one example which I have added. So these are the some of the sample which I have given for my own GitHub account, right? So this is the workflow 2 which is already created just for the demo purpose, so you can just have a look to it. And here you can see we are passing two payload details. One is the baseline number and another is the baseline revision. As per your requirement, you may pass multiple payload detail or a data. So assume that I have a workflow 2 and I want to pass some information before I trigger the workflow, right? Like assume that I wanted to give some parameterized value to that particular workflow, then you can pass as a payload. Okay, and these are some the method which we are using it. So basically as part of this this workflow, we are calling this particular Python script and we are passing some information which is relevant to trigger that workflow too. Okay, now let's talk about the workflow 2 setup. So as part of the workflow 1, we understood, okay, what are the setup we need to do. For workflow 2 setup also I have created a sample, we can quickly review that as well. So this link is available publicly, so you can have a look. So here if you see, one important configuration that we made, it is the repository dispatch, right? With the help of this only, it will accept that particular call to trigger that particular workflow. So here we are giving the type as a workflow 2, right? So this particular event will get triggered whenever there is a REST API call from the workflow 1 and the type of that repository dispatch is workflow 2. Talking about the payload, right? So we also discussed about through the workflow 1 we are passing some payload data, right? And here you can read those data from this particular command, like GitHub event.client payload and baseline tag and baseline number or revision number. So that's all, right? And then here if you see, I have given some sample information, just a echo. Okay, so let's go back to that our article. So coming back here under the configuration, if you see, definitely the repository dispatch, you need to make sure you have to add it in the workflow 2 which you are going to trigger from the workflow 1, right? And some of the payload value. So as I mentioned before, you may add some more payload data also. Just for example, I have given some baseline tag and revision number. Okay, and again this workflow is already available here, so you can have a look, and just it is for a demo purpose I have configured. And here if you see, like as part of this particular step or the task, I'm trying to I'm trying to print those baseline tag and baseline revision number which I have received from the workflow 1. Okay, now talking about the workflow, right? How we can basically trigger the workflow so that the other workflow can be triggered. So as for the example, since I have created two workflow, workflow 1 and workflow 2, and workflow, whenever you trigger workflow 1, it will automatically trigger the workflow 2, right? So we will see that particular. So for that, basically you need to click on this URL this is the public repository. You can have a look to it. And if you go to the action, right here, there are two workflow which I have created. So now for a testing purpose, since that all the configuration we already have made, we'll try to trigger this workflow one and see whether it is automatically triggering workflow two or not. Okay, so I'll just click on run workflow, right, and just wait for a few seconds. Meanwhile, we can also come here. So I think that's all we have information. So here I have given some detail like how basically you can trigger the workflow. Okay, so workflow one is running currently. You can come here and also see the details. So I think it's almost completed, right? So now let's see whether the second workflow is got triggered. So now you see the workflow T is got workflow two got automatically triggered, and it also succeeded. So now if you try and come and see what are the value we have. So if you see here, these are the value also getting printed, right? And this value we have passed through the workflow one. Okay, so that's all from the demo. So that's all for this particular demo. Thanks for watching. And if you have any issue while setting up this particular configuration, you can write in the comment section. I will be responding to that. And the last thing is if you like this video, kindly share it, subscribe it, and don't forget to like the video as well. So thanks for watching.